Today's recipe is a simple spice and garlic potatoes recipe, a recipe that I'm certain you will enjoy when you try it because we are enjoying it a lot. I'm even finding it much better than fries or chips, as we call them in this country. And interestingly, I am sharing this recipe at a time children are at home, and so you would want to try this one. I know you will enjoy that nice garlic taste on your potatoes and have it for your meal, or even as a part of a main meal. As I'm saying, it's very simple to make. So join me for today's recipe. Welcome to Recipes and Hospitality with Clara. This is a channel where we share recipes that are simple, easy to do at home with ingredients toned down just like this one to enhance your hospitality for the glory of God. And if you're new here and this is the kind of content you like, kindly consider subscribing, hit the notification bell. You'll be notified every time I upload new content. I upload this kind of content that is very simple to make with ingredients that are most likely available right where you are. As is always our custom on this channel, we will pray and trust the Lord to grant us a fruitful time as we work through the recipe today. Father, we pray that you be with me and my viewer, and grant that you will be glorified with what I share as we go through the recipe, and everything else we do in the kitchen, grant that you will be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. As we begin, I have already peeled my Irish potatoes or Waru and washed them thoroughly and cut them up into sizable pieces, that is quarters, as you can see, just small enough for a child to plop into the mouth when they are eating them. And then I have also rinsed them in water and allowed them to soak in water. As you know, of course, potatoes are best when they are soaked in water. And because I'm going to make this in two batches, I'm going to transfer half of them, as you have seen me do, onto a sieve so that we can drain out the water really. As you know, with cooking oil, mixing with water, you really want them as dry as possible. You can even also dry them or using a clean kitchen towel. So I'll allow them to drip as I go ahead and finely grate 6 pieces of cloves, because we are going to use 3 for one batch and 3 for the other. And as I'm doing this, my cooking oil is heating up in the background so that when it just gets hot, not too hot, we can begin frying the first batch of our potatoes. So that's what I'm now doing because my cooking oil is hot enough. So I will add in the potatoes. Yeah, enough to fit into this pan. Thankfully, my pan is big, so I'm making quite some amount of potatoes this first round. So I'd already finished grating my garlic. So we are going to fry these potatoes or waru until they are nice and crisp. You know, we want them really crisp and ready. And of course, as we do this, we are stirring frequently, yeah, allowing them to rest a few minutes and then coming in and stirring them, because this also helps them to cook evenly as possible. So as you walk around the kitchen, give them a few minutes, come in again and stir, a few minutes, come in and stir, until they are ready, that is crispy and ready. So at this point, they're almost ready, as you can see. So we will still continue to stir them. Well, at this point, as you can even see, they are basically ready. So you don't want them still, you know, mushy. You want them to have kind of like gotten crispy on the surface. And then we are going to transfer them to a hot pot that is lined with paper towels. The reason I'm transferring it to a hot pot is because we want them to still remain hot as we go to the next step. The next step will require us to work with garlic, and garlic cooks very fast, fries very fast. So that's why I am first letting this first batch cook. But as I'm doing this, the second batch, you will notice at the corner of the video on the right hand side, our second batch is actually frying in the pan. So in a separate pan, I'm going to add about a tablespoon of marge. You can use butter because, as you know, butter is healthier. And because our pan is wide, I'm using a full tablespoon so that it can distribute well. And we are working with marge or butter so that our garlic will stick on our potatoes once we add them to this pan. So add in your garlic, and as for garlic, you don't want to stay very far from it because it cooks really fast. So we are going to fry our garlic in our marge or butter for just a few minutes. When you begin to just see it beginning to turn, you know, a light golden color, some of the pieces, you want to go in with your salt and your spices. That is the turmeric powder as well as the paprika, and any spice that you might like. So you can see it's just starting to turn, and the reason I'm saying this is because once all of it turns to a golden color, it begins to harden and it becomes very hard for it to stick on the potatoes. So you want to time very fast, add in your spices and fry them so that as they fry, they are cooking for just a few seconds. So once everything has come together, we will now add in our potatoes, our fried, already fried potatoes. So because timing is critical, sometimes when you do this, actually the garlic can dry out. But what I found with this recipe is even when the garlic has kind of become too golden, you know, and starting to sound very crispy, the taste, the potatoes will still have that delightful garlic taste. That's why I love this recipe. Even when the garlic seems to have dried out, they just taste so nice. So you're going to significantly lower the heat, you know, very low. You just want to sustain the heat as you stir in the potatoes so that the garlic doesn't continue cooking, but then you try as hard as much as possible to cover every piece of potato with a spice mixture and with the garlic. So once you've stirred, switch off the fire, and then we are going to add on some dhania. This is just to garnish further. You can add in more. I was getting mine from the garden and I realized I don't have a lot, so I didn't put in a lot, but you can put in a little more than I have done. So stir in the dhania or cilantro or coriander leaves. So basically that's it. You can see a very delightful recipe that we have really enjoyed, even more than chips, especially for children when they'd like a quick lunch or a quick snack, or, you know, a side dish for your dinner or main meal, because even as adults we enjoy it. And once I've done this, usually I will just use a paper towel to wipe my pan off so that I can do the same with the marge butter, the garlic, as well as the spices, and do exactly what I did with the first potatoes. We've now done the second batch. We enjoyed this with some kachumbari. Try making this way and enjoy. Enhance your hospitality for the glory of God. You could check out this particular recipe right here, where I worked on a recipe of potato crisps, a wonderful snack for children. As you know, crisps are very expensive in our stores and supermarket, but if you can make them at home, you are going to enjoy the process. Your children are going to love them as well. My children love this particular one a lot, because when you go to the supermarket, I tell them, now just look at how small they are and so costly. So this is another one you're going to enjoy. So thank you so much for joining me. Look out for our next recipe. Again, very simple, very delightful, a recipe that I trust you will enjoy as well. And until then, see you in that recipe or in this one right here.